Your 35% bar in here. Racket. Got a little catch there. I think you can hear it. I think what's happening is the it's sliding off, it's slipping off the little notch you got cut for the blocker lever, and it's actually the trigger bar is picking up the hammer on that secondary notch for the blocker lever, and then it's sliding off. So that's kind of a little irritating, but that's it. Then I get the pull. Okay, I get the brake. Now I got quite a bit of over travel. I've seen some other pictures and videos that didn't have much over travel. When I say quite a bit, it's about 3/32 inch over travel. Not this big deal. Everything's moved forward about 1/4 inch. I only have about 1/16 inch of take up, which surprised me because some of the other guys had like 3/16. But anyhow, there's the pull. Here's the problem. Got the trigger back. No hammer. Rack it all the way back. Release it. No hammer. It's not resting on the hammer catch. I got a, I might have a full auto LC9. I don't know. But that's the problem. If I take pressure off the trigger, there's the hammer. Fire it, hold it, hold the hammer back. You know it should reset. It's not resetting. Take the slide off. Okay. Got it in a half cock position. Okay, I'm going to keep it from firing really hard forward, but I'm keeping the trigger back. Okay, so I got the trigger back right there. Okay, pull the trigger back. I don't care how far I put the trigger back, it's not holding up on the hammer catch. And what's happening is the bar is not resetting. So what I'm seeing is it fires. Okay, when I push down on the bar, I can't push the bar down. If I release a little pressure, release a little more, the bar just is not going down. I got to release the trigger about halfway to get the bar to go up and down, trigger bar to go up and down. So it's not releasing.